Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our concerto competition. We're in the Morris Hall at Concord College, named, of course, after the same individual as the charitable foundation for whom we're raising money this evening. But this, ladies and gentlemen, is a concerto competition. Our entrants are all current full-time students here at the college. So studying music merely goes alongside their academic studies. Seven of them will be performing this evening, and our adjudicator will be Richard Jenkinson. The orchestra specially assembled for the occasion will be conducted by Stavros Kokkinos, and he is the head of music here at Concord College. I shall introduce each of the entrants to you as they come up to play, but we'll begin the evening with our orchestra playing the overture to Mozart's Marriage of Figaro. Would you please welcome, ladies and gentlemen, our conductor, Mr. Stavros Kokkinos.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first piece we shall hear for the competition this evening is the first movement from Mozart's Piano Concerto No. 24 in C minor. Our musician, first of all, is John Zhao. John began his musical journey at the age of five with the piano. He followed the routine of the piano grade exams at the Central Conservatory of Music and passed the top ninth grade in 2018. Since then, he's continued to play classical Western music and also started to take a keen interest in other musical styles, such as Chinese folk music. John loves to share his passion for music with others, and he's taken part in many musical events as an accompanist. He's currently a student in Form 4, our lower school, studying maths, English as a second language, and seven other subjects, including, of course, music. He's hoping to study for a degree in chemistry and pursue a career in chemical engineering. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome John Zhao. John. now, ladies and gentlemen, another Mozart piano concerto, the second movement from number 23 this time, and our musician is Seb Branfield. Seb's also in our lower school. He began his musical journey at the age of six. He's grade seven in piano and is doing his grade eight in the near future. He's been involved in various performing opportunities at Concord and outside. Thoroughly enjoys playing solo piano pieces, especially by Rachmaninoff and Chopin. Tonight's performance fulfills his long-held ambition to play a concerto with an orchestra. He's currently, as I say, a student in the lower school studying for his GCSEs. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Seb Branfield. The next piece we shall hear, ladies and gentlemen, is the first movement from J.S.Bach's Concerto in D minor. This will be played for us by Nico Li Wei Tian. Nico's been playing piano since the age of 4. There's a pattern here, isn't there? What was first a parental decision has now become a passion of his. Having achieved a distinction in his ABRSM Grade 8 piano exams in 2016, he's now aiming for a diploma. Nico's affection for classical music began when he was first introduced to the third movement of Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata. Dumbfounded, as he says, by the sheer ferocity of the melody, he's since then explored many other dazzling masterpieces. Nico has always been starstruck by the groundbreaking composers such as Liszt, Gershwin, and of course, Bach. Aside from his solo repertoire, Nico also enjoys ensemble music making and is always actively seeking opportunities to perform alongside fellow musicians, most often in the form of piano for four hands. He's also started playing the clarinet and the organ in recent years. Nico is currently a student in the sixth form, studying double maths and physics, alongside an extended research project in music. He hopes to pursue a career in music in the future. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Nico Li. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the second half of our concerto competition. This evening is obviously and of course about music. It's a chance for our young students to demonstrate their abilities and to develop the skills of working with an orchestra. But as I mentioned at the beginning, it is also a fundraiser. We're raising money for the Anthony Morris Foundation, and that exists to enable young students who otherwise would not be able to attend Concord to come to this really very wonderful international school and to study here. Tony Morris gave 30 years, someone will correct me if I'm wrong, but at least 30 years of his life to this college. And despite the ill health he suffered in his last months, he remained very closely linked and involved with what was going on. I do recall our 70th birthday event in which Tony took centre stage, and students had come, former students had come, from all around the world. And it was very obvious the respect and the affection in which they held him, not just when they were seated publicly, but in little conversations with them in the corridors afterwards. So I think it's fair to say Tony always wanted to share what this college had to offer in any way that we could with whoever we could. And your being here this evening, your listening to us online, is helping that aim by raising money. So I would just like to say thank you very much. And now back to the music. Our next piece, he says, consulting his notes, the third movement of a Beethoven piano concerto, number 3. And this will be played for us by Davon Halim. Davon began his musical journey at age 4 with the violin and first started piano lessons at age 5. Since then, his love for classical music has blossomed with a repertoire spanning composers of various styles throughout the centuries, from cornerstones like Bach to more contemporary composers such as Widmann. Davon passed the Diploma ABRSM examination for piano performance with a distinction last year. He's proficient on the organ. He currently serves as the organist for the morning services at St Mary's here in Acton Burnell. He's an amateur composer, and he was in the top 10 finalist in the Royal Overseas League's Commonwealth International Composition Award this year. He's currently studying double maths, physics and economics at Concord Sixth Form, and he's seeking to study mathematics at university. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Davon. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you will have noticed that change is afoot. Piano has disappeared. Our next piece is the first movement, Vivaldi's Concerto for Violin in G, and our performer is Wing-Hin Lau. Wing-Hin began her musical journey at the age of 5, with the catalyst being the piano. But not long after, she fell in love with the violin. Little did she know that her ingenuous childlike admiration and stealing her sister's violin would blossom into a passion which she maintains. Playing the violin brings colour into Wing-Hin's life. She can express her emotions freely. Music, she says, is not about what's being played, but how you understand it through your own beliefs. Whilst pursuing other passions, and namely running, she listens to the violin as it gives her mental strength and determination, and simultaneously inspires her to improve. Wing-Hin's currently a lower school student, but after her external examinations, she hopes to continue her education here in the sixth form, studying double maths, physics, economics or geography, and English. Her dream is to become an engineer. Knowing the hard work and perseverance it will take, well, the difficulty she sometimes finds in playing the violin builds on her determination. Not knowing how far she'll come in this competition, she's nevertheless honoured to have the opportunity to compete against other talented musicians. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Wing-Hin Lau.
Thank you.
finally, ladies and gentlemen, the first movement from Vivaldi's Concerto for Two Cellos in G Minor, which not unreasonably requires two students. So I'm about to introduce to you two of our students, Louis Tang and Ronnie Tse. Now, Louis's dedication to his music studies is reflected in his wide and varied range of experience, including orchestral and solo performances and foreign exchanges in Singapore, Hong Kong, Ohio, and most recently here in the UK, as part of Shrewsbury School's Symphony Orchestra trips to London and Birmingham. At the age of 14, Louis embarked on studies in composition and musical theory. He believes that composing helps him to develop a deeper understanding of music and interpretation, as it provides him with an insight into the inner world of music making. Tonight's performance represents for him a lifelong ambition to perform as a soloist with an orchestra. Louis is currently a student in our sixth form, studying maths, physics and chemistry alongside an extended research project. And his colleague this evening is Ronnie Tse. Ronnie started playing the piano at the age of 3. I think that's the record this evening. And picked up the cello at the age of 5. He learned both instruments together until the age of 13, when he decided to focus on the cello after passing the ABRSM grade 8 piano exam. A year later, he'd go on to do the equivalent on the cello and pass that exam with merit. Ronnie says he's had much more free time since moving to the UK for studies. I must investigate that. And so he's been able to spend more time practicing the cello. He was awarded the Shropshire Young Musician of the Year Award in 2018, playing the Elgar Cello Concerto on the night. He also participates in smaller county-level competitions, the Showcase. Ronnie's an Upper Six student, and 2020 will be his last year here in Shropshire. He's an aspiring aeronautical engineer. Ladies and gentlemen, Ronnie and Louis.
Thank you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our students' musical efforts this evening. Although, I would just point out, at least one has managed to infiltrate the orchestra and will be playing again. But it leaves our adjudicator, Mr. Richard Jenkinson, with the not inconsiderable task of adjudicating. We're going to give him an enormous amount of time which to do this, the entire length of the first movement of J.S.Bach's Brandenburg Concerto, at the end of which he will take over from me and duly adjudicate. Stavros, take it away.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a treat we've had this evening. Some wonderful, wonderful playing on different instruments. Very varied programme too. Wonderfully accompanied, of course, by Stavros and the orchestra. So thank you so much for that. Very enjoyable evening. So much drama, so much passion in the way the young students have played this evening. For me, there was one performance that particularly stuck out this evening as being particularly exceptional, and that was the performance of the Beethoven Piano Concerto. It had fire, it had passion, and it had incredible incredible ensemble with the orchestra. This piece is particularly difficult, and it's a conductor's nightmare to catch all those runs, and fantastic, well done for the orchestra. There was an amazing awareness of the way that Davon played with the orchestra. He was aware of what was going on. For me, that really stuck out as being something rather exceptional. So it's for those reasons that I'm going to award the prize for the concerto competition to Davon for his performance of the third Beethoven Piano Concerto. Well done, wonderful. Say a big thank you to all the competitors for wonderful performances this evening, and thank you too for being a wonderful audience. Very warm. Thank you so much for having me here.